doctors world over have said, starts with stress, business stress, family stress, husband-wife stress, children stress, 1,000 stresses, 1 billion of stresses are there. You also have stress. If your friend doesn't talk to you, stress. Suppose you both fight with stress. I am telling you, stress is very common. Now my request to all of you, this is exam time. Few things just keep in mind, please keep in mind, because we have gone through the same routine in our times. I feel only one thing, please. You will go blank in exam if you have stress. You look at the paper, the retrieval from the computer here will become zero. You'll say, I don't know, I knew it. But I don't know what it is now. That will come to you. It will be very hurting when it comes to you. So first rule, all the other days, sleep whatever time you want, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, perfect already. Are you clear? But the day prior to exam, that means Monday's exam, Sunday, there is no chance that you will sleep beyond 11 o'clock. By 10:30, 11, go to bed. Force yourself. Don't get sleep also. No, it's night. I like reading. I've been doing it for so many months. I think I can study now. Don't do that. The stress human body. Where is it booming? Okay. The stress in our body, one of the most important people who have died at a young age is because of lack of sleep. You will feel fresh at that time, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, Sunday night, you will feel very fresh. Why should I sleep? I am fresh. I am perfect already, I can revise everything. Next day morning, somewhere about 11, 11:30, then your brain will go a little dizzy. Tremendous amount of sleep will overcome you and you will not be able to control. I am telling you, you will not be able to control. I have seen this happen 2 years back. One boy who studied till 3 o'clock morning, despite by telling him so many times. And then when he went to exam at 11, 11:30, he suddenly found that he is terribly sleepy. They didn't allow coffee for the boy. Then the excellent examiner, they didn't allow, they said no. And the boy said, I just can't open myself, I don't feel so tired. My request, don't do that. Our body is not superhuman body, it's an ordinary body. It requires 7 hours of good sleep when you want to retrieve. Look at a computer, laptop, or anything which you use. If you use continuously, it becomes hot because energy is being taken. And when you retrieve from your computer, a lot of energy is being taken. So that time, if you don't get sleep, the energy goes down and you feel very, very sleepy. Believe me, you will make a fool of yourself and your exam will be ruined. Day prior to exam, all moderns, everyone insist that you sleep by 10:30, 11, maximum 11. 10:30, 10 o'clock is ideal. Have 7 hours sleep. Get up at 5:30, fresh. Please, I'm telling you again, don't miss this important point. Second, stress occurs when you don't have energy, that is sleep, it ruins. Second is when you don't eat food, especially girls. Now paper is over, now you can eat well. Don't skip breakfast, that's a main meal. Skip dinner. Don't skip breakfast. They say that breakfast should be like a king, lunch should be like a queen, and dinner should be given up to. You should not eat dinner yet. You should just give it up to your best neighbor. Don't take dinner. Avoid. Take little, very little. Have good breakfast. So when you go there, don't miss breakfast early morning when you go. Have a good sandwich. Have one glass of good bonita milk. Sugar is required for you. Don't worry, little baby, don't worry. Sugar is required that day. So please take a good glass of milk, 3-4 sandwiches or 2 parathas. Dhruv, don't eat 25 parathas. Then again you'll feel sleepy. So it should not be too much, it should not be zero. Don't eat too much breakfast. Eat good so that you don't feel your body gets all the energy to digest and it feels sleepy. Third, stress. So day before exam, 7 hours sleep. When you come, eat breakfast. Please don't skip that. Please. I'm telling you because your mind requires energy. Next is you're supposed to be at 10. Be here at 9:45. Talk to your friends. Try and remove stress. General talk. Socialize. Hello. Talk little things. Be socialized. Come early. Look at your roll number. Each time they will change your places. So look at your number on the stick which place you could sit down. Sharp at 10, they're going to open the doors. You're in. Already a hot ticket we're keeping there. Because many children, if you give hot ticket, they lose it. Lots of children. Kya hot ticket kaisa tha sir ye aaj. So we only keep it. We keep it in a table. Let them check. After we only take it back. Don't take hot ticket and go. Don't take the hot ticket and go to room. We'll collect it from there for the next exam. We are doing it because you're small babies. For us, you're small babies. So we'll collect everything for you. Don't have the tension of hot ticket. That's a very important document. Now your papers will be gathered. Now one more thing. It happens every day. The next stress comes. First stress is lack of sleep. Second stress is not eating breakfast. The third stress is hurry. Nothing happens. All that is bakwas. I'm telling you, please don't do that to yourself. Some people don't eat breakfast. They padna usse. Don't make. Sir, I'm coming. You go. Don't get it. You go. And then he realizes, my God, it's 10:15, 10:30. Then he rushes like mad. Panic, stress. Now, what happens in stress time? All your memory banks, which are data banks, which are there in the mind, big walls collapse. Tuck, tuck, tuck. And retrieval is gone. You look at them, you don't know what's happening to you. You don't know what it is. Everything is blank. Because the retrieval is blocked. It only comes with no stress. So please be in time. At least be 9:45, be here. General talk. Relax yourself. Don't ask, ye kya tha yaar, ye kya tha. Chodo usko ho gaya. What have you done, done. When you come here, look at your number. When you come, sit down there. Now, before you enter, please check your pockets for any slips. Check your... Don't be smart, you put a smart watch. And I think they are all smarter than you. Don't write. Some people write behind their cufflinks. Some people write, God knows what kind of invention they do in the socks. Bar bar, he keeps scratching. Some people write on the opposite child's collar. So there is some pattern I write on your collar. Don't do anything, you can get barred for 3 years. They will debar you from 3 years. Don't tell, sir, I don't know how this paper came in your pocket. Nobody listen to you. Nobody will listen to you. So before you enter, you may have kept something. Please see, before you enter, tell your friends also, remove, just remind everyone. Teachers also be standing out and reminding you. Please check your pockets and remove everything. Now when you go in, sit there and announce it. First, stress breaker. First is good sleep, 7 hours, give rest. Second, eat something for the energy. Third is don't panic, don't hurry, don't be rushed. Aram shao, socialize, look at your number, sit down. Once you sit down there, it has been proved in US and Europe, every world over. Our Indian systems are fantastic for breaking stress. So meditation and yoga are a huge success everywhere. They have brought down the low blood pressure of people to unbelievable levels. I am telling you, please, it's a wonderful way. In fact, they say that cancer has also been conquered by doing this. So I request everyone, once you sit down, shut your eyes. Remember your God, which you believe in. If you don't believe in God, look at your parents' image, because they are the gods on earth. Look at your mommy, look at your daddy. And please look at them and do slow breathing. Slow down your system. When I say take deep breath, don't do. You'll make stress, more panic. do Shubh and do Karam Singh. Look at your parents, your God which believes.